Hello friends! If you followed our trip to Serbia on social media, we are here to give you a little bit of a better update. We are in our garden. It's cloudy. You can see Male Karpathy, the mountains behind us in the clouds. But we just wanted to share with you about our trip and more details about the ministry. Our role in the ministry is to offer the Serbian partner that creates the programming partnership in financial and training aspect. And I wanted to read from Ephesians 4, verse 16, that kind of explains the partnership. From Him, Christ, the whole body, joined and held together by every supporting ligament, grows and builds itself up in love as each part does its work. So we are in this ministry together, even though they're doing the work in the Serbian language and other languages, because they are actually managing multiple different regions from the former Yugoslavia.
And a little bit about the Serbian culture that we found out in general. Serbian culture and national identity is strongly linked with Eastern Orthodox, so a little bit more than 80% of Serbs identify as Eastern Orthodox. We saw the biggest Orthodox church in Serbia. It's there in Belgrade, in the capital, and we saw another Orthodox church and an Orthodox shop. So that was an interesting thing. And then culturally, in Serbian culture, there are very close-knit family ties and personal relationships are very important. It's important that we as TWR staff who are helping these national partners, it's important that we visit them and talk to them face-to-face. It's very important culturally. So we were able to do that there with a lady named Bilana. She does a lot. She's involved in all sorts of things with TWR Women of Hope programs. She does a lot with the Roma ministries.
And she recruits and helps find people and workers for ministries in that former Yugoslavia region. So it's great to see how excited and genuinely on fire for the Lord she is to keep moving with the ministry in that region. And we get to see the city of Belgrade a little bit too. Draško works with Bilana. He's quite knowledgeable about the culture, about the history, and he wanted to show us around to get a bit better grasp of what the city history was, why the culture is specifically so connected to Orthodoxy, and for example, for the language. As a little tidbit, he mentioned that the Cyrillic alphabet is very much of a nationalist pride, even though they use both the Latin and the Cyrillic alphabet. So it was interesting to see, and also we took pictures like typical tourists, but it was really interesting to kind of connect the dots about the history and the culture in that region.
And then that evening, after Draško showed us around Belgrade, we went to the office so Bilana could show us firsthand, you know, the various media platforms that they use and the programs that they contextualize and translate or create. So we had a good time there and learned a lot, and we were able to encourage her. She encouraged us, and we talked about future ways that that we can support her.
On our way back from Serbia, we drove through Hungary. And my favorite part driving was that in one of the villages in Hungary, there was literally every light pole had a stork nest. So it was so fun to see how the villages actually built those platforms for the storks to come back when they migrate from Africa. So anyway, that was my favorite part. I love birds.